the most potent plant rooter, and it's completely free. It contains natural plant growth hormones. At the same time, it supports the resistance of new seedlings and has a disinfectant effect. And you can make it in just a few minutes. It's perfect for rooting roses, hawthorns, forsythias, and hydrangeas. When you trim unnecessary branches of forsythias in spring, you can root them. You can also make cuttings from hawthorn or rose branches. All you need are a few willow branches. They can even have leaves on them. You can also use elderberry branches. Every tree from the willow family has extremely potent growth hormones. A willow branch placed in the ground will root easily. That's why a rooting agent made from it is so effective. Cut the willow branches into smaller pieces. They can be a few centimeters long. Transfer them to a jar. Take water, preferably rainwater, and pour it over the chopped branches. Leave the jar in a dark place for a week or two, then simply strain the liquid that forms. It will have a specific smell and density, but that's exactly the kind of liquid that stimulates the growth of plant root systems. Just insert the branches you want to root into it. You can also use the resulting liquid to water rooted plants. It's the most effective rooting agent, and completely natural.
Cheap fertilizer for tomato seedlings. Making it costs less than $1. It is one of the best natural fertilizers and very easy to prepare. Take a handful of rice and put it in a glass bottle or jar, then fill it with water, preferably rainwater. Close it and keep it in a warm place for at least one day. During this time, the nutrients from the rice dissolve in the water. Then, simply strain the water and use it to water your seedlings. Use a syringe or a spray bottle if you're fertilizing small seedlings. This rice water is ideal. It contains plenty of phosphorus, magnesium, silicon, and iron. Thanks to it, plants are stronger and healthier, more resistant to diseases and adverse conditions. Seedlings grow faster, roots are strong, and the yields will definitely be better than in previous years. It's the perfect fertilizer for just a few cents. If you already have tomato seedlings in the ground, simply water them regularly with this water. A cheap and natural fertilizer for seedlings. Just soak it in water. Plants grow like crazy after using it. Small seedlings will shoot up and strengthen their roots. Put a large handful of oat flakes into a jar, then pour water over them, preferably rainwater. Close the jar and leave the flakes in the water for 2 days at room temperature. Then strain the mixture through a sieve and pour it into a spray bottle to use as a liquid fertilizer. Oats contain minerals and vitamins that stimulate root development. They also contain phosphorus, which aids in root formation. This fertilizer can be used for many vegetable seedlings grown in the garden. You can water small seedlings with oat water even before transplanting them into the garden, as well as those already planted in the soil. The oat flakes themselves can also be used as mulch for the soil. After using the oat water, it's best to bury the remaining flakes near the plants in the garden. This is a cheap and effective way to nourish seedlings. It can also be used for potted plants. Aphids are pests that attack the majority of agricultural, fruit-bearing, and vegetable plant species. Aphids reproduce rapidly and are extremely dangerous as parasites, as they suck the sap from plants, weakening their growth and damaging their tissues. When you notice their presence in your garden, take immediate action. This homemade spray repels aphids like tear gas. Only one natural ingredient is needed for its preparation. It turns out that a commonly available spice works wonders against aphids. Add a teaspoon of cayenne pepper to 500 milliliters of water. Pepper acts as a repellent to aphids. Capsaicin, the compound responsible for the sharp taste of the pepper, irritates them. It is a natural pesticide. Aphids, snails, and powdery mildew will disappear from your garden in the blink of an eye. Mix well and let the suspension stand for 36 hours. After this time, strain the mixture through a coffee filter or a cloth to prevent spice clumps from clogging the spray bottle. Dilute the spray in water before using it. Be careful not to touch your eyes during the preparation, as the spice can be irritating to the skin and membranes. Cayenne pepper should only be used in its diluted water form for safety reasons. Once ready, spray the mixture onto plants infested by aphids. Thoroughly spray the stems and leaves, plants in the evening, preferably on a calm day without wind. Repeat the process once every 7 days. This is an ideal spray if you seek effectiveness without resorting to chemical means. What are your experiences with natural sprays? Let us know in the comments which ones have worked well in your garden.
Why are cucumbers packed in plastic wrap? The reason may surprise you. Why are green cucumbers wrapped in plastic while other vegetables are not? Producers of this vegetable often opt for such packaging. It might seem like plastic wrap is an unnecessary addition that generates unnecessary waste. However, it turns out to have an important purpose. Cucumbers are one of the most popular vegetables purchased by consumers. In stores, there are usually two types of cucumbers available: field cucumbers, which have characteristic bumps on the skin, and greenhouse cucumbers, which have smooth skin. The latter are packed in plastic wrap. To understand its purpose, one must delve into the structure of this vegetable. Cucumber consists of over 90% water, which provides its elasticity and also contributes to its taste. The plastic wrap is crucial for the transport and taste of this product. It turns out that precise protection of the skin with its help is essential. It prevents water from evaporating from the vegetable cells, ensuring that we buy fresh, firm, and juicy cucumbers rather than dried out, soft, and spongy ones. The plastic wrap also has a purpose in transportation. Greenhouse cucumbers are often imported from other countries. It protects them from being crushed and, when vacuum-packed, shields them from mold. Despite protection from contamination, it should be remembered that such cucumbers should be washed before eating. Although packaging them in plastic wrap may seem like an environmentally unfriendly solution, without this protection, the vegetable would have no chance of reaching our stores. A more environmentally friendly choice may be field cucumbers. There is no need to pack them in plastic.
I water the cucumbers with one addition. The yields are gigantic. I gather them in full buckets. This fertilizer has been in my family for generations. Every year we have so many cucumbers that we have to give them away to the neighbors. Growing cucumbers can be childishly simple, despite being a plant with high soil requirements. Soils for cucumber cultivation should have a good structure, be rich in organic matter and humus. Proper nutrition for the plant is also important. Unfortunately, cucumbers often fall victim to fungal diseases. To reduce the use of pesticides, it's worth resorting to natural protection methods, among which yeast spray is often recommended. Preparing it is very simple. Crush half a cube of fresh yeast into a bowl. They contain primarily B-group vitamins, carbohydrates, organic iron, amino acids, and trace elements. Next, add a glass of sugar. Mix everything thoroughly and pour warm water over it. Leave it for a while for the yeast to start working. The glucose contained in the sugar will help the cucumbers produce new flowers. Dissolve the yeast mixture in 5 liters of water. Leave it to ferment for a week before using it for fertilizing. It is more effective then. If you don't have time, you can use the undiluted yeast mixture an hour after dissolving the yeast. Water the cucumbers planted in the ground with this mixture. The yeast solution perfectly affects the growth of cucumbers. It supplies the seedlings with B-group vitamins, iron, amino acids, and various trace elements. This is enough to stimulate and strengthen the roots and accelerate plant growth. Yeast has one more advantage. When you water the plants with them, they enter into symbiosis with the roots. Then, other harmful fungi and various disease-causing microorganisms have limited access to the roots. So, yeast protects the roots from various diseases and infections. They act protectively. Moreover, you can use them in two ways. The first one involves preparing a watering solution, and the second one is the spray. The spray remains on the plant leaves, eliminating unnecessary microorganisms and fungal diseases. Just use the spray at least once a month to double the yields. I have been using this recipe for years, and every year I gather a gigantic amount of cucumbers.